Halakha regarding Motzei Shabbat. According to the Halakha, the Shabbat ends when there's three stars that appear in the sky. The stars, according to the Gemara, have to be Benonim, medium stars. And Shulchan Aruch says they have to be Ritzufim. They have to be in a straight row. Not one star over here, and one star over there, and one star in the other area. They have to be in one area. The only problem is, we're not astrologers, and we're not astronomers, and we really don't know what a Kochav Benoni is. It's hard for us to identify. So the Halakha says we have to be Mahmir. And instead of a Kochav Benoni, we have to wait until three small stars come. Clearly, it has to be darker in order to see smaller stars. Again, we're really not too clear on a small star and a big star and a medium star. And what happens on a night that it's cloudy? So therefore, the Hachamim established in each region a time, a set time based on how quickly the sun comes down in that region and how fast the stars come out, and it becomes a formula. So you don't have to look out the window, and you don't have to be concerned about stars. You just have to follow the time. The question is, what is that time? There is two basic opinions. There's the opinion of the Geonim, which is the accepted practice in Klal Yisrael. Now the Geonim can range anywhere between 20 minutes after sunset, up to 42 minutes after sunset. But it depends where you are. So for example, in the old country, in Syria, for example, in Aleppo, they used to wait 35 minutes after sunset, and then Shabbat was over. Sounds like early time to end Shabbat. But in the Middle East, the sun sets very quickly. If anybody ever went to Jerusalem, you see, after 20 minutes after sunset, already it's dark. However, in New York, for example, where we live, it takes a little longer for the sun to set. And if somebody would look after 20 minutes after sunset, it's still light outside. You could still make the blessing on the sun, Birkat HaHama. And therefore, the equation for New York, for the Shitat Geonim, Nachamim said, is 42 minutes. And it's 42 minutes after sunset. Already one is able to assume that the stars are out, and one can say, Havdalah and Dubalacha. However, there's another opinion of Rabbeinu Tam. Rabbeinu Tam, he held that the time is 72 minutes after sunset. And that's a half hour longer than the accepted time. Hacham Avadya, alav shalom, while he was lenient on many halachot, but when it came to Shabbat, he was strict on this. And he held that one should not end the Shabbat until 72 minutes after sunset, at least when it comes to doing melacha, the oraita. Because there's an opinion of Rabbeinu Tam, and according to him, if a person does melacha between 42 minutes and 72 minutes, he can be mehalel Shabbat. And he's Hayav Sekina. And therefore, on something so serious like Shabbat, the Hacham himself was strict. Rabbi Masas, alav shalom, in the Teshuvot, spoke against and said that, first of all, the Minhag is not like the Rabbeinu Tam. And anyway, the Rabbeinu Tam was only talking about in Europe. Because in Europe, the sun sets very slow. So it takes us 42 minutes. In Europe, it took 72 minutes. Rabbi Avadya argued back. There was a big argument back and forth between Rabbi Masas and Rabbi Avadya on this subject. Rabbi Avadya answered back and said, what are you talking about? Rabbeinu Tam was saying his opinion in the Gemara. And the opinion of the Gemara was in the Shabbat. He wasn't talking about Europe. He was explaining the Gemara. Where are the rabbis in the Gemara? They lived in the Middle East. They lived in Baghdad. They lived in Europe. And anyway, they go back and forth on this. And Hacham Avadya says that it's not only the Rabbeinu Tam. There's 10 Rishonim at least but all hold like Rabbeinu Tam as well. We call it Rabbeinu Tam because that's the main rabbi that presented it, but it's many Rishonim as well. Achava Benya once came to New York and he spoke in a Bet Knesset. They prayed Arbit on Motzei Shabbat. They said Havdalah, and now the rabbi got up in a pulpit like this, and they brought from a microphone, and they put it on. I was there, and I was watching exactly what happened. The rabbi took two steps back, and he whispered something in somebody's ear, and they both looked at their watches, and they made a calculation, and then the gabbai came and took away the microphone. The people in the congregation didn't know what happened. So they started to scream, hey, bring the microphone, we can't hear the rabbi. I told them what happened, it's clear. The Hakam knew that they ended Shabbat at 42 minutes. And he is following the Rabbeinu Tam, he doesn't want to talk into a microphone. Well, it's still Shabbat for him. And therefore he told them exactly in a half hour, you bring the microphone back. All of a sudden, in the middle of the Darasha, they bring the microphone back, and the Kahal, who doesn't understand, said, why did he bring it now? How come he didn't bring it a half hour ago? They couldn't hear for a half hour. They had no idea that he was being strict in order to follow Shittat Rabbeinu Tam. Why am I telling you this halacha now? Because there's another case where Rachama Benyah was stringent on Shittat Rabbeinu Tam, and that's Motzei Kippur. Kippur also is a fast deoraita, and is punishable by karet. And therefore, those that end the fast at 42 minutes after sunset, fine, they have what to rely on. That's Shittat Geonim, that's the Menhag. But someone that eats in that half hour, according to the Rabbeinu Tam, is Hayav Karet. And therefore, a person fasted 25 hours. So an extra half hour to be strict, to be mahmir, according to these shittot, according to the rabbi, is something that is proper. Not only that, the pasuk writes, "Besharu b'nei Yisrael et ha-Shabbat, la'asot et ha-Shabbat." Now, we know "Besharu b'nei Yisrael et ha-Shabbat," he can be shomer Shabbat. The Ibn Ezra said, "Ki yishmera Shabbat, el yishmerenu." Those that keep the Shabbat protects them. More than the Jewish people keep the Shabbat keeps the Jewish people. But what does it mean, la'asot et ha-Shabbat? To make the Shabbat. We make the Shabbat, we don't make Shabbat. Shabbat comes by itself. We make the holidays. Bedin makes the Hagim, Mekudash, Mekudash, Mekudash. But what do you mean, la'asot et ha-Shabbat? You can't make a Shabbat. You can take the biggest rabbis of Israel. They cannot all of a sudden say, we're making a Shabbat today. The Shabbat is automatic, it's every 7 days. That's why, for example, on Shabbat we say, Baruch Atah Hashem, Mekadesh HaShabbat. However, on Hagim we say, Mekadesh Yisrael VeHazemanim. Because Yisrael makes the Zemanim, but Yisrael doesn't make the Shabbat. Shabbat happens by itself. We don't say, Baruch Mekadesh Yisrael VeHashabbat. Yisrael doesn't make Shabbat, Shabbat is an automatic. So what does the Pasuk mean? Veshamru b'nei Yisrael Shabbat, la'asot et ha-Shabbat. I heard once from Rabbi Shlomo Amar, the former chief rabbi and chief rabbi of Jerusalem today, that he explained this problem. He said that really we're supposed to accept Shabbat a little early and end it a little late. He said if a person goes to a hotel, he requests early check-in and late check-out. Shabbat is not worse than a hotel. It's Ma'an Olam Abba. Why would a person want to check in the last minute and leave the moment it's over? Who wants to enjoy it? Who wants to go back to the weekdays? Who wants to... So therefore, he says, the custom was that on Erev Shabbat, they would accept Shabbat at least a half hour early. Example, we light the candles at 18 minutes before sunset. And already at that time, although we pray Mincha, but we stop doing Mincha. But he says, in Jerusalem, they accept it even before 18 minutes, a half hour before. And if you're going to follow the Rabbeinu Tam, instead of ending Shabbat 42 minutes, you end Shabbat another half hour as well. That's a lot of time. You're adding an extra hour to the Shabbat, but not everybody can add an extra hour to the Shabbat. So he says, cut it in half. At least if a person would accept Shabbat 15 minutes before the time, like we said, candle lighting, 18 minutes, and he would accept 15 minutes after Shabbat, it would be delayed the Shabbat. Why? Because Rabbi Moshe Feinstein, alav shalom, he had a different calculation. His calculation was that the Rabbeinu Tam in New York is 50 minutes. It's not 72. He held, if you follow 50 minutes, you're following really Rabbeinu Tam. It's a calculation he made. So if a person does 15 minutes before Shabbat, he delays the Shabbat 15 minutes as an example. So therefore he has a half hour. He has a half hour every Shabbat. So that means every month, how much hours of Shabbat did he add? Four Shabbatot, a half hour each Shabbat. So he accepted upon himself 2 hours. And he says there's 12 months. So there's 12 months. So altogether, you accepted upon yourself 24 hours. That means you made for yourself one extra Shabbat of the year. And that's what the Pasuk is. Shamru b'nei seder Shabbat. They have to be shomer the Shabbat before and after. And by that, la'asot et ha-Shabbat. You will make an extra Shabbat. Because with the Tosefets and the calculations, you'll have an extra Shabbat during the year. And therefore, one has to realize that if there's such a inyan to be mosif, so therefore all the more so on Shabbat itself, to take advantage of the day. I'll conclude with a story that happened with Rav Chaim Volozhin, where he saw the boys in the yeshiva on Shabbat in the Beit Midrash. They were talking, shooting the breeze, as they call it. So the rabbi came in and said, you boys are talking, you're wasting time, you're better off going to sleep. Because anyway, the rabbi says, Shabbat is Rashi Tevot, Shina b'Shabbat ta'anu. So you might as well fulfill what the rabbi said, Shina b'Shabbat ta'anu. So one of the students there was a little mechutzach. He turned to the rabbi and he said, but also Shabbat can stand for Siha b'Shabbat ta'anu. That talking on Shabbat is also ta'anu. Rav Chaim Volozhin looked at him and told him, on you I say the pasuk, Lev hacham nimiro, Lev kesir nisirah. The hacham goes to the right, and the imbecile goes to the left. He said, if you take the letter sheen, if you make it a sheen, the dot of the sheen is on the right. But if you want to make it a seen, you have to put the dot to the left. So he said, I said shina b'shabbat, lev hacham limino, I put the dot to the right. But you said siha b'shabbat, lev kesin l'smono, you put the dot to the left. And therefore, we see from over here, it's not enough just to add hours. If a person is going to add hours to the Shabbat, that means he understands the value. That reminds him that he has to keep the Shabbat as well. It says in the Gemara, "Lo nitnu Shabbatot v'yamim tovim Yisrael, ela b'kdei she'asku b'hem b'Torah." That the reason why Hashem gave us the Shabbat was so we could study Torah. And the great Rabbi Rav Chaim Palachi says that the Torah shebichtav corresponds God's name Yudke Vavke, because the Yudke Vavke has five parts to it. How does it have five parts? The Yud has a kotz on top, that's the first part. The Yud itself is the second. The He, Vav, He is the next three. So the Yud Kevavke has three parts. Kutso shel Yud, the Yud, the He, the Vav, and the He. Yud Kevavke is keneged hamisha Moshe Torah. And then he says, that's the Shem Yud Kevavke. And the Shem Elokim is keneged Torah Shabbat Peh. And that's why when we take out the Sefer Torah, on Shabbat, we say, Ata ureta lada'at. Ki Hashem Hu Elohim. That we're reminding ourselves that today is the Shabbat, and therefore Hashem, which is the Rashi Bechtav, and after the, we read the Torah, we have Shi'ud, we open up the Gemariot, we open up the Rashi Ba'al Peh. And therefore one should take advantage, especially now that we're coming to the last Shabbat of the year. This is the last Shabbat of Tavshin Ayin Heh. Already next Shabbat is the New Year, it's the first one. Kol Olecha Ara Haitu. Everything goes according to the end. If we follow the last Shabbat properly, then Borei Olam give us credit as if we did all the Shabbatot of the year. Yiratzon, Shekadosh Baruch Hu Yanchilenu, Leyom Shekadosh Shabbat, Haya Olamim, Amen.